This is a customized 1960 Cadillac Coupe De Ville two-door hardtop.
Yeah, Mike, to your point, you know, I got to say, Steve Davis does a nice job. It's sort of like a nice album with one song flowing to the next. And indeed, going from a Boss 429 to a Cadillac Coupe De Ville, only at Barrett-Jackson. But I got to love this engine. This is an LS with twin turbochargers. And again, there's no kit you can buy to make this happen. This all has to be custom fabricated. And that plumbing is all stainless steel, which is then, of course, TIG welded together by hand. But nicely presented, very symmetrical, lots of power.
The 1960, similar in some ways to the 1959. Of course, the 1959 had slightly higher fins on the back. And of course, it had that iconic bullet taillight. Now we've gone to this rectangular version with the circle taillights inside.
Love these wheels. These emulate the look of the Cadillac wheel cover, which would have been a 14 or a 15-inch diameter stainless steel stamping back in 1960. But these are undoubtedly computer-generated on a CNC mill. Beautiful.
By the way, if you're wondering what this license plate means, RD250, it's Road to 50, 50th anniversary for Barrett-Jackson. All of the cars here at Barrett-Jackson have that on.
And the bubble roof treatment extended from the low-line Chevy, quote-unquote, all the way up to Cadillac. And here again we see the thin A and B pillars. The dogleg A pillar there. A dogleg refers to the fact that it kicks back in toward the car. You can back smack your knee on that easily. But again, it's a beautiful styling touch. Massive curved windshield.
Seems like just a few minutes ago we were hyperventilating when a car hit $200,000. Yeah, now it's another $200,000. 500 horsepower coming out of that engine at the rear wheels. Not just coming out of the engine, but at the rear wheels.
To your point, Rick, generally speaking, you lose about 20 to 30% of your power as it makes its way from the flywheel to the tire. So that's probably 700 horsepower at the crankshaft, only with turbos.
The fins on the 1960, the tail fins, were every bit as high as they were in 1959. But with the tail lights moved down to the bumper, these fins look lower than on the 59. They continued again for 1961, and then they got emasculated.
By the way, that black paint has six coats of clear coat on top of it. That's how deep that paint is.
Oh, knockout bid. Somebody just jumped it from 235 to 250, and that did it. Sold for $250,000.